Hello, Rob Vane here, and today we're going to look at how to put text into Adobe InDesign CS 5.5 and how to manipulate that text. So, today we're looking at, of course, a leaflet design. Now, at the moment, I've selected page one, but what I'm going to be putting onto this leaflet is the body text, and that needs to go in the inside of the leaflet, so we're going to need to click on page two. Now, first things first, we're going to need some text frames. There is a couple of ways you can do this. The most appropriate for our use here is to do three text frames, one here, one here, one here, and then link them all together. So to do that, we're going to go over to the text frame button here on our tools panel, which we're going to click on. As you can see, our menu up here changes, our control panel changes depending on what we clicked on. So, remember that the black line is the edge of the page and our pink purple lines and these blue ones we've added here, the middle one obviously is the fold. These are our safety margins. We don't want any text going outside of those. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a box that goes from there to there and then across to there. That is our first text frame. Now we need three of these. So if I go onto the selection tool, I want to duplicate this box. The easiest way for me to do that, well, I could cut and paste it using copy and paste, but I'm going to hold down Alt and then left click and drag to duplicate that box. And then I'm going to do it again. Alt, left click, drag. I've now got three text frames. If I do that, you can see I've got three text frames. Now I need to link them together. That way, anything I start typing in here will immediately go on to the next box and into the next box. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the first one and then down here this little box there, if I click on it, this icon appears, and if I move over to there it turns into a chain. That means I'm linking these two boxes together. This box is now linked to that one, and I'm going to do the same, click, link. All these three boxes are linked now. Anything I start typing in here, when I get to the bottom, it'll automatically go into this box here and then into this box subsequently. Now I need to put some text in it. Well, obviously I go into text, click where I want to start text, put my text and just start typing any old random gibberish. Okay, now, as you can see, just like any old word processor, I can highlight it, I can change my font. I've got to drop down a different font so I can use. In the interests of ease of communication, especially for a leaflet, I would recommend that we use Arial, Helvetica if you've got it. I haven't, so Arial will have to do. Now if I click on this box here, this drop down menu, it gives me different kinds of text. I can have narrow, I can have regular, I can have italics, bold. If I really want something to stand out, then black is the option to go for, but we're going to stick with regular. Obviously this allows me to change the size of the font. For your main text I wouldn't have anything less than 12 in a leaflet like this, maybe something like 14 or maybe 16 for headings. What I can do, if I delete that, if I haven't written anything yet and I just want to see what my layout would look like, I can go to type, fill with placeholder text, and it will fill it with gibberish. Now, let's have a look what options I've got. If I select Control A and select all my text. Now, at the moment, I've got it at font 12. That's the font size. A nice easy way to change the size of font, and this works in Word and everything as well, is if I hold down Control Shift and then comma, it makes it smaller. Control, Shift and full stop makes it bigger. Now, at the moment, this is called my leading. That is the gap between the lines. It should be about 110% of whatever my font size is. So if my font size is 10, then it should be 11. If it's 12, it should be 14. 14.4 is close enough, I'll leave it at that. Other things we can do is we've got our alignment. Now, at the moment, it's left aligned. I could square align it. I don't like the way it leaves these big gaps. It could be a bit messy. This one's quite good because it gives you square, but then, you know, like sort of like left justifies your last line. That's not bad. If I'm going to use that one, this is your typical standard left align, I would go over to paragraph here and I would unclick hyphenation because I don't want words split in half with hyphenates like this. So there you go, that is tidier. For a leaflet, I would probably, in fact, it doesn't do all that. I would probably use this one. It looks a little bit neater, but again, I would make sure that I turn off hyphenation. By the way, I've scrolled off that using the mouse wheel. If I want to center things, fit to that. If I want to center it, Control Alt 0, centers the double page. Control 0 does the same thing if you're a single page. Right, okay. Obviously, I've got other options. I'll go back onto this. I can do things like quite a common thing you'll see in magazines that obviously you don't get on leaflets, but is you can have a drop capital. If I've got a paragraph, this is my drop capital tool here, and that gives me drop capitals. But I don't want that. So, about one. Obviously, I can do things like, you know, your first line might be bold. Common thing you'll get on magazines. We're not doing a magazine, we're doing a leaflet. How do I change the colour of my text? Well, if I highlight that and go up to this button here, and it gives me all sorts of options. I can make whatever colour I like. Anyway, Control Z. Well, another one I can do, for example, is I could click on the box itself, change the colour of the box, and then click on T, select the text, and change the colour of the text. Problem with that, though, as you can see at the moment, is that the text going right to the edge. Now, if I go onto the up here, I can go to presentation. We'll see what it looked like when it prints. And as you see, this text is far too close to the edge of the box. Escape to get out of that. So what I can do is click on the selection tool, click on the box, and if I go to right-click and then go on to text frame options, which is these Control B for short, make sure preview is selected, and I can put a bit of inset spacing on it. Could one of you do click on that link, hit OK. Now if I do that now and go on to presentation, you can see it doesn't quite go to the edge. I've got a bit of a gap around it, it looks a bit tidier. Anyway, don't want that. Control Z, keep doing that until it gets back where it was. There you go. Right now, I don't want this text. I've already written some text, which I did in Word, where I've got the advantage of things like spell checking. I can import Word documents straight into InDesign. If you're going to do that, I would recommend you don't put any particular formatting on your text. Just write it. Well, probably stick to whatever font. If you want it to be an Arial in your leaflet, write it in Arial. If you want it font 12, do it in font 12. You can fiddle that later, but don't avoid things like numbers and bullet points and all that kind of stuff because it causes problems. So, what we need to do is we need to go File, Place, which is Control and D for short. That's a good one to remember. You use that a lot. Navigate to where your text is. Double click. And it should automatically go in there, like that. Now, obviously, I'm going to leave that for the front cover, so I'm going to get rid of that. What we don't want is lots of big empty space like this on it. So, what I think we're going to do is we're going to make these a different font so they stand out a bit better. Now, since this is the largest one, what I want to do is change the color first of all. Now, I want this to be a particular color green. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click on this and I'm going to type in the CMYK colors. C for cyan, magenta, yellow, and K is for black. So we're going to change that to 70. I'm going to make that 28. I'm going to make this 100 and that 12. And that's the particular kind of green I want. So, at least it should be. Yeah, there you go. Excellent. So what I'm going to do is highlight that. And I think I'm going to put these into all capitals, which I can do using that button there. Now, I want it to be a bit bigger. So, 14 looks okay. So we're going to make all those the same color. So if we go like this, should have all that already in there somewhere. Is it that one? Don't think it is it? Here it is. What did I decide to make it? 14. So we'll make that 14. And do the same with all of them. No, having done that, if I make that 14, it might be a bit big. Nope, that's fine. Ah, thought it would be. Okay, let's change the colour before we do anything. Maybe I need to make that 11. Looks a bit small though. If I make that back to 14. What I might be able to do is squeeze the letters together a bit, which is called kerning. There you go. I've actually made the text close together. It's the same font size, but the text is closer so it fits. Right. That's better. I like that. Okay. Go on to that. Let's take a bit of time. Maybe a copy and paste format you can use. I don't know if there is. That would make life a lot easier, wouldn't it? Right, now we've got hyphenation on there. So, select all, control A, paragraph, turn off hyphenation. Right, we might need to. Oh, I've done that in all capitals. Again, change the kerning. There you go, better. Right. There you go, that's a little bit tidier there. Alright, so. That, I think, I might keep for the back. Cut that out there. Control X is cut, remember? Let's put it over here. Paste. Oops. Nope. What have we done there? Control Z. Undo whatever I did. There you go. Remember that later. Right. Okay, now that's getting somewhere. But I want some numbers on this. See, this caused a problem again. So let's adjust the kerning. Oops. No loop. Right, 3. Cause a problem of making it too close together. Capitals, just the kerning. Adjust the kerning. Ah, there you go. Pretty good. What size have we got that at? That's at 12, that's at 14, that's okay. Right, what we also need to do, I think it needs a bit more design on it. What we can do is, if I hold on shift to select multiple boxes, I can drag it down. There like that. And I could have another box up here, for example. This is something like 10 ways. In fact, caps lock on. 10 ways to quit smoking. Actually, if I go on to a Word document. We'll find out exactly what it says in there. That's better. Control C for copy. Control V for paste. Let's do that in all. No, should we all do all capitals? We'll just use. What's wrong with that? Caps lock's on. There you go. You'll have this in title case with the first letter of words is highlighted. But again, we'll have this in Arial. And we'll have it in black because it's a title. We'll use Control, Shift, and Full Stop to make it bigger. 42. Let's try 43. What if we do a 44? Is that going to be too big? A little bit too big. But we could just knock a kerning down a little bit. That's better. No, in fact, we'll have it at 43. Because what I want to do is text frame options. Right click. Text frame options. Control B for short, remember. We're going to align it to center. We're going to put a bit of inset space in. Like that. Select OK. And we're going to fill the text box with our color. And make the text white. Because you want a nice contrasting color. Like that. There you go. Okay, let's have a look what that looks like. Not bad. Could be worse. Night escape. Maybe we need more of a gap between that and the top of the text. Let's try that, see what that looks like. Yes, that's neater. But that gives you most of the basics. What I wouldn't want you to have is something like this. Look, can you see how that starts there but then goes on to that? That is a bit untidy. So I think what we need to do is select these again, move it up a little bit so we've got a bit more room, and then do that. Now, can you see how we've now got a little red box there? That means we've got overhanging text. We've got text that's disappearing off the page. What I think we're going to do here is, again, cut that out of there. And we'll put it on the back somewhere later. That doesn't look too bad though. It's okay to have a little bit of empty space down here. Ideally, you can get rid of it though. It could look neater. There. I'm not massively happy about the bits of empty space down here, but that's life. Okay, escape. And I think what I could possibly do with is a box down here, perhaps. So we'll just draw a text frame. That's too big. Squeeze it down. I'm going to fill it with the green. There you go. Let's have a look, see what that looks like. Just gives it a bit of an extra design to it. There, not too bad. Let's have a quick look at how I've got that formatted. If we control A, I wonder if it looks better like that. I think what we've got here is this text has moved over a little bit. I'm going to nudge it using the arrows. That's better. That's a bit tidier. Yeah. Obviously, remember that you need to keep saving this at a regular basis. So control save is control S, save as is control shift and S. I think we should call it something like leaflet or something. And that gives you the basics on how to do text and how to manipulate text. There are more complicated things you can do, obviously, but if you need help with anything in particular, first suggestion would be Google it. If you still can't find the answer, come and see me or Simon or Steve Pidd or Brittany Cully and anybody who happens to be around, and they'll be able to show you what to do. Okay, so any questions? You can email me on robert.venn@thomroth.ac.uk. All right, thank you very much. Bye.